Hello! Our work aims to analyze the behavior of the classical and quantum dynamics in a system of interacting matter and light, the Dicke model, which can be described as two non-linearly coupled harmonic oscillators. This is how our classical analysis is done. We use the phase space to visualize the classical evolution. There are two pairs of canonical variables, small qp and big qp. We place a Gaussian ensemble of initial conditions and show its projection in color. The outer solid black line encloses the available phase space at this energy. Initially, the ensemble moves as a whole, leaving the initial region, marked with the inner black outline. At this energy, the system behaves regularly, so the ensemble comes back to the initial region periodically. Because the different initial conditions in the Gaussian packet have different velocities, the ensemble starts to deform, covering the complete orbit. We finally reach equilibrium. The ensemble has completely covered the phase space accessible to its evolution. Note that this is not the complete phase space, because at this energy, the system is not ergodic. This is another ensemble of initial conditions, at a higher energy, where the system is chaotic. As before, the ensemble moves away from the initial region as a whole, but this time, it does not come back. Instead, it starts to break apart as the different initial conditions wander off exponentially. This ensemble quickly fills the available phase space entirely. This is what we call ergodicity in statistical mechanics. To quantify how much an ensemble is spread in the phase space, we measure the amount of color that is inside of the initial region at any given time. We call this quantity the classical survival probability.
Now we show how our quantum analysis is done. The quantum survival probability is the square norm of the overlap of an initial state with itself at a later time. Our initial states are coherent states, which have the same Gaussian phase space distributions used in the classical version. We show the survival probabilities for the ergodic state that you just saw, classical in red and the quantum one in blue. Both start at 1, drop to 0, and finally equilibrate, with the blue line displaying quantum fluctuations. Now let us show you the same plot for another state also in the chaotic regime. This state shows periodic revivals and a much higher quantum equilibration value due to an effect known as quantum scattering. These different behaviors of the survival probabilities can be traced back to structures in the energy distribution of the coherent states when expanded in the Hamiltonian eigenbasis. This distribution is called the local density of states. We show the components of the previously shown initial states in the eigenbasis. On the one hand, the ergodic state shows a local density of states that looks randomly distributed inside a normal distribution. On the other hand, the scattered state shows a clear pattern in its components, resembling a cone. Let's see the consequence of that pattern in the classical dynamics. We plot the classical survival probability in the bottom panel, which, remember, measures the amount of color inside of the initial region. As in the previous cases, the ensemble moves away from the initial region as a whole. Nevertheless, it comes back to the initial region periodically. This periodic behavior slowly fades away, as the ensemble fills the available phase space completely. Still, a more densely populated thin region is visible for very long times. This region contains an unstable periodic orbit, responsible for the periodic revivals of the classical survival probability and the source of the scattering of the quantum states.
In the article, we explore in detail the effects of scattering, quantum spectral correlations, and classical separatrixes in the different behaviors of the classical and quantum survival probabilities. We hope you find our findings interesting.